Just when I thought the era of flagship killers has ended, the Mi Note 10 Lite landed in and proved me wrong. Mi Note 10 Lite has got some surprising capabilities and we'll dig them all out today. Welcome to the Mi Note 10 Lite final review. It would be massively appreciated if you can hit that thumbs up button, that red subscribe button and the bell icon. The very first thing I would like to talk about is the design and build. Mi Note 10 Lite is a phone fully built out of glass surrounded by an aluminium frame. Front and back both have the Gorilla Glass 5 protection. This is a heavy phone weighing over 200 grams. The back is so shiny and so lovely, it casts a multitude of shades when exposed to light. I am always cautious while carrying this phone as I might end up dropping it, but thankfully it is safe so far. On the right side is this phone's volume rocker and power button embedded right into the frame. These are quite soft keys and in the same line is this phone's SIM card slot too. You can only put two SIM cards here, no space for the microSD card whatsoever. You can find this little orange rubber sealant on the SIM card slot. This is there to protect this phone from water. Now, it doesn't mean this is a water resistant phone, but it can definitely handle a splash. Another big feature of this phone, the headphone jack resides at the bottom, accompanied by a bottom firing speaker grill, a primary mic, and a USB Type-C port of this phone. At the top of this phone, you can find a big IR blaster and a secondary noise cancellation mic. What I liked the most about this phone's top and bottom is its flat profile. It can literally stand tall without any support. The highest amount of sophistication has been added into the display of this phone. A 6.47 inch Super AMOLED Full HD Plus Gorilla Glass 5 protected HDR10 supported curved display on the front, holding that water drop notch at the top. Extremely thin bezel profile and a tiny chin at the bottom. Although it's got a brightness level of 430 nits and it worked well when the brightness was at max, but as soon as I lowered down the brightness, I did not find it as good. Now this is a Super AMOLED panel and it lives up to the expectations very well. I watched videos on this phone in the dark under extreme light outdoor as well and had no issues at all. Even with the viewing angles, no problems with the colors at all. Everything looks crisp on this fabulous screen. Curved display has its own class and there is nothing better than this, and having a curved display on a mid-ranger is nothing less than a blessing. It does have the always-on display feature. Options to change the color tone of the display exist in the phone too. This is certainly a flagship killer feature. But wait, there is something I want to talk about. In my extensive use, it felt like there were some touch latency issues. I'm not sure if it was a problem with my phone or everyone else is facing these issues, but at times, especially while tapping some buttons towards the corners of the screen while playing the games, the response was not that good. Yes, I did have the edge protection turned on, but even if that is turned on, the corners of the screen are supposed to work fine. Let me know in the comment section if you are facing any such issues on your phone. At the top of the dot drop notch of this phone is its call speaker, which works quite well. And here we have its proximity sensor as well. Now some of you have been asking me about the proximity sensor's performance and it works really well. I did not face any problems at all. The phone has a very nice and solid haptic feedback. You might have to lower down its intensity. I wish we had the MIUI 12, but at the moment we have the MIUI 11 on this one, which runs on the top of Android 10. This phone has the basic features like the dark mode, the screen recorder is there, Mi Share, and navigation gestures are there to enjoy the full screen experience. Dark mode can be useful on a Super AMOLED panel for sure. It offers more versatility in terms of options to change the behavior of certain features on this handset. Xiaomi has further impacted a RAM of 6GB and storage chip of 128GB, which happens to be a UFS 2.1 standard. The biggest drawback that I see here is the lack of a microSD card slot. Unfortunately, 128GB is all you will have to live with. For security, there is an optical reader under the display with a very weird animation. Fingerprint scanner takes a bit to unlock the phone but works well. Face ID unlock is something that I won't recommend as it unlocked my phone even when I was wearing a mask. On the performance end is a Snapdragon 730G 8nm chipset coupled with Adreno 618 GPU. AnTuTu score is over 272K. The details of this test are on your screen. You may pause and check it if you want. In the speed test, this phone easily defeated the Galaxy A71 and went neck and neck with the Redmi Note 9 Pro, and the Galaxy A51 was defeated as well. I played a couple of games on this handset with the PUBG being the first app. At first, I played it in the smooth Ultra settings. Ultra is the max frame rate available. The game's performance against my expectations wasn't up to the mark. It kept missing frames, lagged and stuttered. This was quite disappointing knowing how good this phone performed in the speed test. The real gaming test was quite the opposite. Highest frame rate in this mode was 41 frames per second, and you can see it on the top right corner of the screen how inconsistent it is. I played it in smooth ultra settings for an hour, although it did not hinder my gameplay, but the real gamers can definitely face severe issues. I did switch the game to the HDR and high settings, and this time the game did not lag and the graphics were too good. But of course the FPS went under 30. Thankfully the phone doesn't heat up while gaming, the temperature remains quite normal. Call of Duty Mobile, however, with very high graphics and FPS settings, hits 60 frames per second, and I did not face any issues at all in the multiplayer mode of this game. Speaker performance of this phone is just average. I would have loved having a stereo speaker, but there is only one bottom firing speaker, and here is the speaker test for all of you. In the camera department, we get the main Sony IMX686 sensor. Remaining details are on your screen. The rear camera supports videos up to 4K at 30 frames per second with EIS and 1080p at 60 frames per second. Features like the night mode, super slow-mo, hyperlapse and a very good pro mode are there. And yes, what I must tell you guys is, the pro mode doesn't have video pro mode and slow motion doesn't support the front camera slow-mos. While both these options are there on the Redmi Note 9 Pro and Note 9S, it's quite disappointing to see that Mi Note 10 Lite doesn't have them. Images from this handset generally come out with very good and deep colors. Edge detection is amazing, images are full of details, and saturation is also very good. The main camera works well with all the images, including the normal and the portrait mode images. Mi Note 10 Lite's camera performs greatly, mostly when the light is very good, especially outdoor, but it can underperform in low light. The ultra wide and macro cameras are equally pathetic. Front camera takes good selfies, but the selfies lack details. I have done a full camera review of this phone and I'll attach it here. Watch it if you want. There's a huge 5260mAh battery in this phone, and it is definitely the most attractive point here. I did a mega battery brain test, and the Mi Note 10 Lite secured second position in that test, right next to the Galaxy A31. This phone lasted for 11 hours and 16 minutes in that test, and took about 85 minutes to hit 100 from 0 via its 30W fast charger. Battery drain was conducted without a SIM card in the phone, so bear in mind that the real life results can be different. Whenever I left the phone at 100% in the night, it dropped to about 88% the next morning. The battery performance is good, but I think there is still a lot of room for this to improve. Now, during the charging process, the phone heats up too much to a point where you can't even hold the phone, but cools off as soon as the phone hits 100%. And this brings us to the conclusion. Xiaomi Mi Note 10 Lite is a beautiful device, but I think it's not a flagship killer yet. And here is why I think this. While Xiaomi cannot add the missing microSD card slot in this phone now, here is what the company can definitely do. First of all, the company should roll out the MIUI 12, as there is no sign of the new firmware anywhere. MIUI 12 will definitely bring the missing camera features, including the video pro mode and the front camera selfie mode. Xiaomi also needs to improve the touch performance. The touch latency issues need to be fixed as soon as possible. The cameras need to get better in the low light. Ultra wide and macro cameras are not what they should have been. Xiaomi also needs to do something for the availability of screen protectors of this phone, as they are not easily available in the market and a curved display is pretty much vulnerable. The battery performance still needs an improvement as well. With all those features improved, the super premium build, amazing display, extremely fast charger, this phone will definitely kill the flagships. Let me know what do you have to say about this phone. Please hit the like button if you loved my review. Also make sure to hit the subscribe button. With that said, I will sign off and see you all in the next video.